Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him, and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He who is guided by the will of Allah, no one can misguide him, and he who is misguided, no one can guide him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The main title of my khatira is, I quote, قَالُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. All who you believe, protect yourself and قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ and your families, your kids, your wives, your parents, نَارًا the hellfire in which is fueled by human beings and the stones. Reason why this khatra came to my mind. Without exaggeration, at every few days I receive a request or a telephone call or someone through a mediator from a family member asking consultation because of kids. Hello, assalamu alaikum, doctor, please help me. My daughter decided to take the hijab off. A few days later, hello, assalamu alaikum, please, doctor, help me. My son started questioning the authenticity and validity of the Quran. Hello, assalamu alaikum, please help me. My daughter and my son, both of them, they are attacking me and telling me Allah has no right to punish anyone who does anything wrong with his personal private sexuality. Hello, assalamu alaikum. My daughter and my son, both of them, they stopped praying because they believe no one has the right to force them to pray, and so on and so on and so on. Now, one of the common grounds between all of these people, that nearly all of them, they went to public schools. One of the things that at least I noticed, and I know some people, they don't agree with me. I'm not saying this is a by default condition, but the majority of them, they share this point. So my message is, please, we need to know that we are completely responsible before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and our kids. Actually, our biggest job in this dunya is to protect them and to take them with us to the Jannah, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُمْ بِإِيمَانِ الْحَقْنَا بِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ. This is our biggest wish, that inshallah all of us will be from people of the Jannah, and those whom we love from our families to follow us. So message number one. Now we have to realize we are living in a secular country. Public schools are based completely on the concept of secularism. So they will not change the system for you or for me. It's your duty to protect your children in what pertains to your faith. Okay, I know not everyone can take his kids to private school or Islamic schools. Okay, I know. Now, how can I compensate? Even though I have a response to this, I witnessed some people who say it is expensive, but they change their cars every year with the highest expensive cars. It's not everyone who does not go to private schools because of money. No, some of them, they don't want to pay, some of them. So anyway, this is not my point. My point, let's imagine that you can't take your kids for whatever reason to Islamic schools. And I know, I'm not saying Islamic schools, all of them, they are angels. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying they are the best, but at least the risk is less, to be clear. Number two, you can't afford going to Islamic schools for whatever reason. Does this mean just to submit yourself for your faith? No. You have to find other solutions for your kids, such as weekend schools, Quranic schools. Plus, and this is the most important thing, do we give special quality time with our kids from the very beginning? We discuss with them, we feed them with knowledge and love and respect, and we allow them to ask the questions that in many Arab cultures they are not allowed aslan to ask. So therefore, when they go to the school, they start questioning, they will find this secular or atheist or whatever person with all kind of friendly attitude. They will be feeding them with their answers. You will be losing them, they will be gaining them. So please, part of the concept of قو أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا, protect yourself and you seek the knowledge. You do some efforts to understand the doubts about Islam, against Islam. Read, attend some courses, do some efforts so that when your kid asks you, how can I prove that Allah does exist? You say, عيب عليك يا ولد. Don't ask this question. No, it's a normal question. How can I prove the existence of Allah? It's a normal question. It's his right. What's the color of Allah? استغفر الله عظيم الكفر. يعني he's a child. This is his way of thinking. You can tell him in another way. طيب واي حجاب اصفر دمي قطع لسانك عيب عليك تش كف على الصباح. You know, why it's fard? Ask, explain to her the concept of chastity, the concept of purity. What does it mean? Why, when, how? Why do I have to pray? Does Allah need my prayer? No, Allah does not need your prayer. طيب why Allah is forcing us? Okay, calm down. تعال. طيب what if I don't know? Go and seek the knowledge. Ask. Go and ask, simply. So please, let's think seriously. Wallahi, I'm not exaggerating if I'm telling you. Tens of our kids, they are stepping forward towards atheism, towards hating Islam in your homes. Some of you are praying in this masjid. They are stepping forward toward this. So let's always keep advising ourselves, remind ourselves, put more efforts in reading, seeking the knowledge, giving more love, more quality time with our kids. Gaining more money is not everything. If you, alhamdulillah, you have a normal, some kind of stability in your financial status, please spare a lot of time to sit with them. Let them love you. Let them consider you their friend. Let them express their needs. The fact that you decided to be in this country, you have to pay the tax. Part of the tax of sitting in a free country that your kids will think completely freely. Part of the side effects, they might be attacking your, in their point of view, traditional faith. So you need to prepare yourself how to convince them, how to let them understand, how to let them love what you love. Otherwise, we might be falling in a serious shortage. And it could be, wal-iyadu billah, I mean, the result could be losing them from the faith. Wallahu alam. Yes, brother.
So, wouldn't you also bring a point that when kids go to a football, they're always talking about, if you don't do this, you'll go to hell. And then it keeps piling up. You have to pray, you have to do this. Do you think that may seem overwhelming and consider, though, when they go to school, they'll meet with their Christian friend, they'll be like, yeah, I don't even go to church. And if I do, it's only once a week. You have to pray five times a day. Wow. They make Christianity seem like this holy grail and super nice place. And you go to Islam, and it seems like this pressure of work and effort,
yes,
and lack of freedom.
I agree with you. Jazakallah khair. That's why we need always to do it in a nice way. Plus, we need to give the justification for the teachings. It's not just do it. Because as Sheikh Nabilsi has a very beautiful saying, I hope I'm quoting him very well. He said, إِذَا عَرَفْتَ الْآمِرَ اسْتَمْتَعْتَ فِي تَنْفِيذِ الْمَأْمُورِ وَإِذَا جَهِلْتَ الْآمِرَ تَفَنَّنْتَ فِي التَّهَرُّبِ مِنَ الْمَأْمُورِ. If you know the one who commanded you, i.e. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will enjoy applying and performing his commandment. If you are ignorant about him, his real greatness and azama, you will be fully skilled how to escape from, you know, applying and performing what you have commanded to do, because simply Allah does not mean anything for you. It's, I agree with you, we need to explain, we need to fix misconceptions, we need to give the justifications with love, passion, understanding, logic, common sense. This needs, requires by default what? Ilm. But sometimes part of the problem that the father does not have the ilm, the mother does not have the ilm, in addition to the fact that they are very busy. But so we need all the time to keep reminding, to provide as much as we can. And by the way, now after the world became global village, And the online teaching, now the hujjah, the argument from Allah against us became much more better. Now nearly even people of 60 and 70, maybe 80 years now, age, they are able to deal with Zoom now. Do you know what is Zoom? 10 years ago, 90% of anyone above 60, he was not able even to use a normal mobile phone. Any simple application, they can't even press it. What does it mean? Just reply, ask. Now, most people of Earth, they know how to deal with complicated applications. Free courses, free online communications, YouTube channels, free knowledge. You know, the accessibility to educate yourself by the will of Allah became 10 times better than 10 years ago. So it's just your will now. Please, please, make a schedule, consult someone, ask someone. Make some kind of arrangement how to educate yourself so that you will be able to educate your kids. JazakAllah khair. I'm sorry for taking a long time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.